for me, I feel like a child, because that's when we were there. We did homework in there.
Thanks to our archives team, Walt's office has been restored right down to the tiniest detail.
People would ask me all the time, you know, where's Walt's office? And we'd point it out from outside. And every time I came up here, I just thought, oh boy, I'd love to put Walt's offices back in, because we had all of this in storage. People have seen bits and pieces of it, but I always thought it'd be so wonderful to be able to put it back into its original place and see it as Walt actually left it. With the 75th anniversary of the studio this year, we thought, well, gosh, it's on everybody's mind, the historic nature of the studio itself. And so we approached senior management. We put together a presentation and made a deck and said, these are all the different things that we would do at the office. Figured out a budget, how much the restoration would cost. They said, yeah, that's fine. Let's go ahead and do it. So we started in June. All of the restoration work was done here on the studio lot by studio artisans and craftsmen. So the Disney Mill, the electrical department, and the AV people, the painters, everybody was from the studio. And so it was done internally. They just put their heart and soul into it, found actual objects around the studio lot and around the building that were original, you know, openers for the doors, or find light switches that were appropriate, and they would take them out of offices that had been remodeled and put the real ones back into Walt's. 95% to 96% of this office is original stuff.
Just looking around his office reminds you of his devotion to his family, his curiosity, his relentless creative passion. We put this permanent exhibit together to serve as a source of inspiration for us, a reminder to have great ambition, to take bold creative risks, to constantly innovate and push the limits of possibility.